नमस्कार। हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। मी माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर रमेश चंद शर्मा, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर एंड HOD, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फॉरेंसिक मेडिसिन एंड टॉक्सिकोलॉजी, फैकल्टी ऑफ होम्योपैथिक साइंस, JVWU। टूडेज आवर टॉपिक इज मेडिको लीगल इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ इंजरीज। मेडिकल डेफिनेशन ऑफ द इंजरी। इंजरी और वुंड्स इज द ब्रिच इन द नेचुरल कंटिन्यूटी ऑफ एनी टिश्यू ऑफ द लिविंग बॉडी। मेडिकली ऑल इंजरीज आर वुंड्स। दीज वर्ड्स इंजरी एंड वुंड्स आर ऑफन यूज्ड इंटरचेंजेबली। लीगली डेफिनेशंस ऑफ इंजरी। Section 44 IPC define injury as any harm whatsoever illegally caused to any person in body, mind, reputation or property. Only bodily injuries are wounds. Hence, all wounds are injuries, but all the injuries are not wounds. Hurts. Section 319 IPC. Any bodily pain, disease or infirmity caused to any person is called hurt. Assault. Section 351 IPC. Any offer of threat or attempt to apply force to the body of another in a hostile manner. Execution of such acts amounts to battering. Classify injuries. Injuries are classified in three ways: medical classification, legal classification, and medico-legal classification. In the medical classification of injuries, the mechanical injuries, injury caused by application of physical force; chemical injuries, corrosive acids and alkalis; thermal injuries due to cold, frostbite, trench foot, immersion foot; due to heat, burns, dry heat and scar, wet heat. Miscellaneous. Electrical injuries, radiation injuries, firearm injuries and explosive injuries. Legal classification of injuries. Legally, injuries are classified according to the severity of the injuries. Simple injuries, grievous hurt, dangerous injury in living, fatal injuries in death. Medico-legal classification of injuries. For medico-legal interpretations, injuries are classified as accidental injury, suicidal injuries, homicidal injuries, defense injury, and fabricated injuries. Differentiate simple injuries, grievous hurt, and dangerous injuries. Simple injuries. Injuries that are neither serious nor dangerous to life are called as simple injuries. For example, abrasions, skin deep laceration on the limbs, etc. Grievous hurt. Section 320 IPC gives a list of injuries which constitute grievous hurt. All other injuries which do not fit into any of the clause of grievous hurt are simple injuries. Grievous hurt, section 320 IPC. Emasculation, permanent privations of sight of either eye, permanent privations of the hearing of either ear, privations of any member or joint, permanent destructions of power of any member or joint, permanent disfigurations of head or face, fracture or dislocation of a bone or tooth, any hurt which endangers life or which causes the victim to be in severe bodily pain or which prevents the person from following his ordinary pursuits of life for a minimum period of 20 days. Dangerous injuries. Any injury which causes imminent threat to the life of the individual is a dangerous injury. And endangering injuries is an for which if the individual is not admitted to the hospital and surgical intervention had not been done, he could have died. When the injury leads to death of an individual, then it is called as fatal injury. Medico-legal importance of abrasions. Abrasions are the most important medico-legal injury. Abrasions are produced at the site of impact and are useful to find out over which area of the body force was applied. Indicate the direction of force. The torn layers of the epithelium are hip up towards one end of the wound, indicating the direction of application of force, the direction of movement of the body when hit or dragged over a fixed surface or object. Medico-legal importance of bruise. It is a sign of violence. Bruise need not always be simple injuries. It is commonly accidental or homicidal and less commonly self-inflicted. Type of the object can be sometimes be identified in cases of pattern bruise. Time of assault can be assessed by the color change of the bruise. Motive of the offense can be identified from site of bruise. Medico-legal significance of laceration. It is a sign of violence. The place of appearance can be identified by the presence of foreign material such as mud, dust, gravel, etc. Laceration over the face is considered as a grievous injury since it is produced a permanent scar which amount to disfigurations of face. Thank you.